Good morning, students. Work from home online classes from St. Angel Public School. As you all know, during lockdown period, we are working from home. So, students, today we are going to start Flamingo's next poem, An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum. The poem has been written by Stephen Spender. First of all, clear the name of the poem. Elementary. Elementary means primary. In Hindi, it is Prathmik. Slum, dirty settlements, means Gandhi Bastiyan. In this poem, poet has described a scene of classroom which is situated in an elementary school in a slum. First of all, know about the poet. Stephen Spender's lifespan is 1909 to 1995. He was keenly interested in politics, but he declared himself to be a socialist and a pacifist. His work includes number of books such as Poem of Dedication, The Age of Being, The Creative Elements, The Struggle of the Modern. He also has written an autobiography, World Within World. In this poem, An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum, Stephen Spender presents a despairing picture of a school classroom in a slum. He deals with the theme of social injustice and class inequalities. He suggests that these children studying in schools in slum will remain narrow in their outlook. The style of the poem is very simple, straightforward, and lucid. Lucid means clear, spurred. Now, come to the first stanza. The stanza begins with the poetic device repetition. Far, far from gusty waves, these children's faces like rootless weeds. The hair torn around their pallor. The tall girl with her vague down head. The paper seeming boy with red eyes. The stunted, unlucky hair of twisted bones, reciting a father's gnarled disease, his lesson from his desk. Come to the first line again. Here we find far, far is written for two times. It means poet want to emphasize the situation of these slum children. So he has used here repetition, the poetic device, from gusty waves. The image gusty waves shows that these children are far away from the luxurious settlement of city dwellers. They are unable to fulfill their basic amenities. So it is said that they are far away from the gusty waves, from the stormy waves, means the living standard of city dwellers. These children's faces like rootless weeds. Here again, children's faces are compared with the rootless weeds. Rootless means without roots. Weeds means unwanted plants. Means the children are called unwanted plant in the society. They are completely ignored in the world of rich and powerful people. Here, the poetic device is simile. When we find like word in the poem line and the comparison is given between two things, then the poetic device is simile. Here the poetic device simile. The hair torn around their pallor. The hair means their hairs are scattered around their pale and withered face. They are looking very untidy with uncombed hair. The tall girl with her vague down head. There is a girl who is sitting there with her head bowed down because she is in state of depression. She is feeling burden of her responsibility and she is depressed due to the perpetual state of her poverty. The paper seeming boy, another boy is also there. Here the paper seeming boy is the paper, the boy is looking as thin as the paper. So here poetic device is metaphor. If we find the comparison without the word like and as, then poetic device is metaphor. It is very easy to identify this poetic device. There is comparison, but as and like words do not exist, then the poetic device is metaphor. With red's eyes, red's eyes indicate fear, insecurity and hunger. All these things clearly seem in the boy's eyes. So his eyes called red's eyes. The stunted, unlucky hair of twisted bones. Stunted means undeveloped. Unlucky hair, hair means successor of the family. Twisted bones, twisted means bent. Here the boy was suffering from a disease in which his bones has twisted, reciting a father's gnarled disease. Gnarled means knotty. Knotty disease which he has received from his father, he has inherited from his father. So he is suffering from the gnarled disease. So he recites his lesson from his desk. The words to learn: gusty, stormy, rootless, without roots, weeds, unwanted plant, pallor, pale face, weighed down, depressed, stunted, undeveloped, hair, successor, twisted, bent, gnarled, knotty, reciting means telling. Now come to the poetic device of this stanza. Far, far, here we find poetic device repetition, like rootless weeds, simile, paper seeming boy, metaphor, red's eyes, again metaphor, father's gnarled disease, here also metaphor, because boy's thin and weak body is compared with his father's diseased stricken body. So here poetic device is metaphor. There are some images also used in this stanza: gusty waves, rootless weeds, the paper seeming boy and twisted bones. Now come to the second stanza. At back of the dim class, one unnoted, sweet and young, his eyes live in a dream of a squirrel game in the tree room other than this. In this class, there is a sweet and young boy is also sitting at the back of the dim class. Dim class, this image shows that there is no proper arrangement of lighting in the classroom. The classroom is looking very dull. One unnoted. Unnoted means unnoticed. He is not noticed by anyone because he is sitting at the back side of the classroom. His eyes live in a dream. The boy was dreaming of squirrel games or the games like this, because the squirrel is coming and going out from the tree room, and he imagined the tree room is full of fun and pleasure. So he is not present in the class mentally. He is just physically sitting there, but he is completely busy in dreaming of the squirrel games. Words to learn here: dim, unclear, unnoted, not noticed, tree room, hollow or empty part of a room, tree. Now poetic device, squirrel game and tree room, metaphor. In both the images, the poetic device is metaphor. Students, start this poem in your fair notebook with the all difficult words, and the stanza wise summary I am going to upload for you, and assignments is also there. So try to solve them by after reading the summary and going through the all the difficult words. Thank you.